how the teams exchange pleasantries here in Trinidad and Tobago. Again, Sean St. Jacques, our entire crew, happy to have you with us on our continuing coverage of the CONCACAF Girls Under 15 Championship. Really starting to get to the nitty-gritty here with teams fighting for positions at the end of what's been a really fun tournament. Starting lineups for both teams, we jump right in. Cuba's 11 under Silvio Minoso. We mentioned it, a lot of attacking talent to look out for in this one. Sonaris Borregos and Yosmeida Leanne Isaac are some of the notables in the lineup, along with Lismarian Fragoso, Salate Caridad Medina, all certainly capable. I should mention as well that there's some big players starting the game on the bench, most notably Yaisalis Lopez and Annalise Calvo Blanco, who have both really shined in this tournament for Cuba. Shayla Valladares captains the Cuban side, and they will be in their navy blues. They're taking their team photo off to the left. And Bermuda are back in their pink kits today. And they'll be captained by Zalay Showers as the two captains meet with our officiating crew in the center of the pitch. Alex Billeter of the United States is our head official. The Cayman Islands, El Salvador, and Honduras are also represented amongst our on-field officiating crew for our first game of a triple header today. Again, we mentioned that Showers is the captain for Bermuda today. Don Vickers is the head coach, and here is his starting lineup. And again, really strong talent here as well. Look at Avery Taylor, Daly Outerbridge, and Tate Glasgow, along with Mayari Trott. All of them are capable of making a big, big impact. Milan Gibbons-Thomas as well could be an attacking threat. Nalini Myers gets the start in goal. Should also mention, though, there's some big talent on the bench as well. Janiyah Seeley, Azay Burrows, but most notably, Evans Welch begins the day on the bench. She has been Bermuda's top scorer at the tournament. So we could see some of the big names on both of these two teams as far as an attacking side of things as the match progresses. Again, a triple header for you today. Three very, very fun games, potentially. All of them for places in League B standing at the end of the CONCACAF Girls Under 15 Championship. This game is for fifth place, and it is going to be a fun one. These two teams have been two of the best we've seen in League B to this point, and both were very close to potentially making an even deeper run towards the League B final. So this promises to be an interesting one, to say the least. And again, we've had some great themes at this tournament. There's been a lot of goals, a lot of quality goals, some great games, wonderful saves and defensive interventions as well. That's because we've had some great quality on the pitch from all the teams involved, really. And we are expecting more of the same today to begin the morning. Well, Bermuda are in pink. They'll kick us off. They'll be going from left to right here in Trinidad and Tobago. All that separates us from kickoff is the sound of Alex Billeter's whistle in the middle of the park. Yeah, these are also two teams that have been well represented as far as the fans are concerned, so you'll be hearing some of their support as the match moves along. The American referee's whistle gets this one underway here in Arima, Trinidad and Tobago. Again, 35-minute halves, 70-minute games we've come accustomed to here. Players have really had fun at this tournament, but now it's time to see where they're going to end up when the final tally is made. And again, if we do stay scoreless or tied, which I must say we have not had that yet at this this section of the under 15 championship. There will be penalties to decide it. No extra time. We'll just go right to the penalty spot to confirm the fifth place finisher. Good start here from Bermuda early on. Ball is curled into the penalty area. Allison Miranda in goal gave it a look, but it goes out of play. That was Tate Glasgow trying to find a teammate inside the penalty area. Cuba will settle for a goal kick with a minute played. It's going to be interesting to see how these two teams get acclimated. You can understand why some of the bigger names, some of the top goal scorers have been put on the bench at the start of this game. They've been playing a lot of minutes over a four-day period. But again, if we get down to the end and it's a tight game, which could very well be between these two, we could see a few of them enter the fray. As Bermuda are under some heavy pressure here, and they're going to win a corner. Cuba. After Bermuda were forced to just clear it out of play. You could hear Alini Miners, I should say, trying to get everyone positioned defensively for the Cuban corner. Upcoming. Alini Miners has had a very strong tournament in goal for Bermuda, I must say. From the corner. Ooh, that was a chance to get a header onto it. I think the closest to it was Liz Marion Fragoso. Certainly a capable goal scorer. Fragoso got back onto it and thought about unleashing the shot. Not quite able to do so. And well, Bermuda are going to get this cleared. That's a lovely ball played down the far side. Bermuda don't quite have the numbers yet, but there's help arriving. It's curled into the middle, and it's going to be cleared out for a Bermuda corner. Good response from Don Vickers' group, and they will get a set piece at this end of the pitch. There is Don Vickers. I'm sure he's happy with that. Good response from Bermuda. And they'll get an early opportunity here to try to create a chance to score, really. Try to get a teammate picked out inside the 18-yard box. Well, in the end, it fizzles out. And the possession swings back to Cuba. Miranda. I'm just trying to ease Cuba back into an attacking threat here. This is Borregos. Lovely pass to split the defenders there, and it could open up here for Cuba. On the near side, this is Medina. And Medina tried to play it through. Bermuda had it covered, but it's sent out to the far side. That's a lovely touch from Borregos, who slides it through. In the end, Miners, he's there to collect. Great build-up play there from the Cubans, but in the end, no end product. Nice ball down the near side. Medina is going to get onto this. Cuts it towards the byline. And it's going to trickle out of play. That's going to be a goal kick. Well defended, by the way, by Bermuda. Well good step in. Chance to win the ball back, but Bermuda are able to quickly follow up on it. It's played down the line as well. That was promising initially there from Bermuda. It still might not be cleared here yet. It's laid off. It's lovely give and go play here. That was a chance for Gibbons Thomas. And again, Bermuda not going to just let this one slide. They get possession back. And now Cuba finally are able to clear their lines here. Well, that was one of the issues yesterday for Bermuda in their big game against the Dominican Republic. They had chances early in the match, but the Dominican Republic really started to dominate and dictate the play after that, and Bermuda were not quite able to recover. Well, they've really bounced back well from that in these early stages. Yes, Cuba have also gotten off to a promising start, but Bermuda have shown already that they are up for the task today, that is for sure. It'd be tough to bounce back, especially for these two teams after the tough way that their route to the final ended yesterday. But they both are off to promising starts. Nice pace down this near side. It's crossed into the middle. And Miranda watches it flash by. It'll go out of play. That was a nice run. Gibbons Thomas, we talked about it earlier, is certainly an attacking threat for Bermuda, and she shows why here. Great ball into the middle, but only one player to aim at. Fantastic effort. And she's a bit unlucky that her teammates didn't get there in time to possibly make something of what was a very good ball played across the face of goal. Can Bermuda stay on the front foot here in the early stages? That's going to be more of a shot, I think, than a pass. It'll go out of play. And Cuba will be able to get possession back here. Miranda is able to get it back out. Borregos under pressure. It's going to be sent upfield. Good pressure from Bermuda here. Don Vickers applauds. They quickly win the ball right back. Now then, can they create something here? Again, Gibbons Thomas with the cross. And then there's a trip in the penalty area. But I believe it's going to go the other way. Oh, well, Gibbons Thomas. Oh, I see. She did put an arm into the back of the Cuban defender. That's well spotted by the referee. Live, it looked like there might have been a trip in there inside the penalty area. But the American center official, Alex Belletta, gets that absolutely spot on. It's a Cuba free kick. Gibbons Thomas ends up falling under her own footing, but again, the contact came much earlier on the push in the back, and Cuba are able to defend the situation there in the end. All of a sudden, we're starting to see more and more Bermuda possession and pressure. Medina, lovely give and go. Ah, but Medina was offside. That was clever. Good build-up play initially. But the assistance flag goes up to end the sequence. Nice job winning the ball back. Another good ball into the middle. But I'll tell you what, it's a wonderful catch by Miranda. Gibbons Thomas continues to be an attacking factor in these opening minutes. But Allison Miranda makes a wonderful catch. Well, it's been these defensive moments that Cuba have had to get right early on in this one, and they have, to be fair. Medina continues to try to follow up, but that's going to go Bermuda's way. And they will get a chance to reset the possession here. Miners gets there first for Bermuda, but does give up the throw. Chance to cross this centrally. Echevarria, oh, tried to take the shot on. It was blocked. And Bermuda come up the other end. So that was an opportunity there. Diana Esther Echevarria almost found an opening there to unleash an effort, but again, well defended. This time by Bermuda's defensive unit, I should say, really. There was multiple players who got in the way of that shot. Now then, coming up the other end. Bermuda looking to try to find the opening goal here. It's rolled in for Avery Taylor, who in the end is going to keep possession for Bermuda, but couldn't hang on to the ball. Those will be two other players to watch. We've seen good things already from Gibbons Thomas, but Daly Outerbridge and Avery Taylor, a couple other key players for this Bermuda side and potential targets of this upcoming corner as well. Outerbridge will actually take the corner. Oh, and it's on the doorstep here. Cuba clears it. Another shot comes in, and it trickles over the line and into the back of the net. Now Bermuda just would not be denied on the doorstep. And after such a positive start, the team in pink jump out in front. Great ball in from Outerbridge. I have to say, Cuba did so well defending this. A couple of clearances off the line. Another blocked shot. It took a deflection, and it goes in for the opening goal. That was the shot. It took a big deflection off a Cuban defender. And just before the cooling break, Bermuda lead by a goal to nil. Well, it was such a chaotic sequence. It was actually tough to tell if that shot was going on target. But I must say, it looks like Samuels is the one that's going to get credited with the goal. And Nyla Samuels scores her first goal of the tournament. And we told you the supporters would be heard from. They were thrilled with how that sequence turned out from a Bermuda point of view. I must say, credit Cuba, because there were two big chances earlier in the sequence that they were able to get cleared that looked surely like they were going to end up in the back of the net. Wonderful effort from Silvio Minoso's defense, but Samuels gets another shot away. Again, it did take a deflection. And Miranda was so close to getting there. Great effort to almost get a hand onto it, let alone keep it out. And it just squeaked over the line. And I must say, Bermuda, they've been gaining momentum more and more as the half moved along, and well, it ends up being Samuels who puts her name up in lights in this fifth place game at the beginning. What will be the reaction from Cuba down a goal? Oh, tiptoeing the near touchline here. That was a good effort. That was Isaac, who of course has scored for Cuba at this tournament. Couldn't quite keep it in play. Ooh, that's a good run on this far side by Crometa. Clever skill, just to try to keep that going. Fragoso tries to cross it. And it's really good effort here from Cuba. They have earned a corner from some strong build-up play. From the corner, it was just over Daniela's head. Cleared, but not definitively, Borregos. And then on the turn, it's a push and a chase. Bermuda can maybe counterattack here. Up the other end. Wonderful run. Oh, the run continues. Lovely hesitation move. On the cutback, there's help available, but Cuba will get possession back. I think that was Avery Taylor with a wonderful run. But she runs out of room and out of time. But Bermuda had a chance there to regain possession. Not quite. Although back and forth it goes in the midfield. And now Bermuda pick it up. Lovely 1-2 passing to try to pick their way through. That pass ahead is going to be blocked and cleared in the end. Taylor. Taylor steps back in to keep Bermuda with the ball. And now Cuba are able to clear their lines. Echeverria stays with it after the challenge came in. Fragoso, two defenders on her, and she's gonna be forced back. Daniela is gonna be fouled. That's a free kick for Cuba. Bit of an overzealous challenge from Daly Outerbridge, to say the least. Free kick for Bermuda as we tick down on 10 minutes plus stoppage time left in the half. Gibbons Thomas. Great run! And the shot is blocked. Oh, that could have been deflected anywhere. Huge, huge block defensively for Cuba. Milan Gibbons Thomas continues to try and make things happen for Bermuda. Cuba looking to break up the other end. It's a lovely touch and chase up ahead. It's played centrally. That was a chance for Echeverria. Bermuda cut it out. That'll stay with Bermuda as Alice Daniela knocks out of play. Here's the earlier chance from Gibbons Thomas. That was a critical block. That was Asia Galina, who was able to get a huge deflection on that. Bermuda stay in possession, trying to possibly increase their lead, although that is going to be a giveaway. Fragoso for Daniela. Plays it back to Fragoso, who cuts in field. Oh, and had the right idea, tried to find Medina. It rolls through to Nalini Miners. Miners will send it ahead. From the throw, it's going to go out for a Bermuda throw once again off the deflection. Now Bermuda already were able to score once earlier in the half. From this throw, it's going to go right back to Cuba. That's one back. Gibbons Thomas. Well, there was a touch in there, but Cuba will get clear. 5 minutes plus stoppage time left in the half. Echeverria continues to fight to get the ball back here. Maybe a little too much on her challenge. So we get a talking to, as this will be a free kick for Bermuda, as that was actually taken exception by Dill. Isaac couldn't quite link up with Echeverria. That's a nice ball played up ahead. Echeverria could not quite take the ball with her. Bermuda and come up the other end and maybe get some numbers towards the penalty area. This will get a throw pretty far up this side of the pitch. Takeaway, and Cuba defensively just able to swarm enough to win the ball back. But can they build up the other end? Bermuda have been closing down all attacking pathways. This one's still up for grabs inside the penalty area. And the battle for possession is going to yield a Cuba throw on the near side. Out there from that was Outer Bridge. Didn't appreciate the challenge, and well, it's because she was being held back by Alice Daniela. Well, surprised Daniela didn't pick up a yellow card for that. That was pretty blatant. Just the free kick. So wait to see how much stoppage time is going to be at the end of the half. More good Bermuda build-up play here. But it's just going to be out of the reach of Gibbons-Thomas. Again, that was another promising opportunity that didn't quite come out. Well, it's a Bermuda throw as we are into one added minute at the end of the half. Bermuda have the lead, trying to get a chance to maybe extend the lead at the end of the first half. They might get that chance here, but that's going to be cleared away at the edge of the penalty area. Dill. Nice ball onto the near side. Gibbons-Thomas wins a corner. Isabel Portela with the critical touch defensively for Cuba. And this Bermuda corner, you would think, will be the last act of the half. This is where Bermuda scored from earlier. Nice high boot just to keep it going. But Bermuda can't get a shot away. And that will end the half here in Trinidad and Tobago. Really, really strong half, I must say, from Bermuda's point of view. Cuba got off to a pretty solid start. But then Bermuda really started to grab the momentum. They grabbed the goal as well from a corner kick opportunity. And then they really halted the Cuban attack as far as limiting their outlets where they could possibly hit in transition or just in the normal run of play. It certainly sets up things interestingly for the second half. We'll see how substitutions could play a part as well in this fifth place game. At the half, it is Cuba 0, Bermuda 1. We'll see how the addition of Lopez impacts the second half for Cuba, which begins here. Cuba will hope to get off to a fast start. Getting one of their strong attacking players involved could be a game changer. We'll have to wait and see. And also, again, Bermuda have some really strong players waiting in the wings as well. So we will have to wait and see how all of that impacts the match in the second half. Meta follows up for Cuba. Cleared. Bermuda do still get possession. Barry. Back to Barry on the near side. This is part of what Bermuda have been doing well in this first half. Playing through Cuba's pressure. And seeing what it yields up the other end, really. That was handled on a potential deflection there. It's a Cuba free kick. Down this near side. Gabby Trott has scored here in this tournament. Making up good ground there and wins a throw-in for Bermuda. Maybe start hearing some of pitter-patters of Mother Nature starting to impact this game a little bit. We've had a little bit of rain during the time in this tournament. Early on in the group stage, it's been really nice and clear the last couple of days of action, but a little bit of precipitation here at the start of the second half. From the corner, it's another chance for Bermuda to score. It was up for grabs. It's still not cleared. Lopez sweeps it up. That's huge for Cuba. But they do give up the throw. Now those are huge, huge defensive interventions. It's going to bounce in behind, and looks like the offside flag is going to go up against Gibbons-Thomas. Cuba defend it well, and they win a free kick. Remember, this is the first of three games we have for you today. Barbados and Grenada coming up next. And then to finish the day, we have Antigua and Barbuda taking on Curaçao. A spin and a shot. Miranda comfortably collects. Oh, we've seen Bermuda score long distance goals in this tournament. Same with Cuba, frankly. Miranda holds well there and stops the opportunity in its tracks. But Bermuda's pressure helps them win another throw-in. Oh, it looks like Cuba are gonna make some more changes here. Annalise Calvo Blanco is going to come on. She's been huge at this tournament for Cuba. She'll come on to help things out. Emily Diaz is on as well. Lilianis Torino Fletes is also going to come on. She's also been very important. She replaces Fragoso. Vites has had multiple assists in this tournament for Cuba, going back to the group stage. Here's Blanco. Blanco's been a big-time goal scorer. As you see there, Diaz comes in for Crometa to help things out defensively, where Cuba need to continue to fight. Flightes steps right in that midfield, and Bermuda do handle it initially here. It's played up ahead for Avery Taylor. Helped along towards Gibbons Thomas. You see there, Blanco for Echeverria. That's a huge change because Calvo Blanco has had a really strong tournament. As this could be a chance for the shot. Outer bridge blocked. Second opportunity. It's gonna be blocked wide and out for a corner. After it was followed up on nicely by Tate Glasgow. Good cutback by Glasgow, and then it's blocked out of play. Glasgow nearly scored yesterday as well. I think before anything further will occur, there's a player down for Cuba on the far side. Really starting to pick up here now. This is probably the most we've seen of the rain at this tournament, Trinidad and Tobago at least. And another unfortunate part of this situation is that Isabel Portela is really struggling here. Might need to be substituted out. You can see her frustration. She wants to help the cause for Cuba. We'll, of course, await confirmation on that, but see by her frustration that Silvio Minoso, after just making a triple change and has made four in the half, might have to make another one here. We'll wait and see on that. Meanwhile, Bermuda have another corner where they've been very dangerous all game. Can they add on to their lead? A corner. Had some whip on it, but I tell you, it's going to go out of play. A little too much, although I must say, we've had multiple games where corner kick takers have nearly scored an Olympico, a direct goal from a free kick, so say from a corner kick. It's happened, I think, almost four or five times. We've seen players come close. That one needs to dip a little bit more along with the curl and whip that it had on it. But here comes a shot. Oh, it's a laser beam into the back of the net for Bermuda. What a strike! Milan Gibbons Thomas with a screamer! Another candidate for goal of the tournament gives Bermuda a 2-0 lead. My word! This is absolutely pulverized into the back of the net. It's a Gibbons-Thomas gobstopper. And Bermuda's lead is doubled. That just flashed through the pouring rain and was buried into the top corner. What a strike, and what a goal. Cuba come up the other end, goalkeeper commits. Calvo holds up the play. It bounces around and Bermuda just about escapes. Back and forth all of a sudden. Now, we've seen some long range goals at this tournament, but none of them were hit as sweetly as that strike from Gibbons Thomas. It's her first goal of the tournament, and what a goal it was. Cuba now come back from two down. We're already having some trouble, down by one. A lot of the attackers are out there now, but it's gonna be double the work the rest of the way. Puts Bermuda in a corner. And a foul is going to allow them to get out of it. That's a free kick. And that was Isaac pushing the back. And Bermuda will get a chance to send this ahead. Is at some point we will get to see that Gibbons-Thomas goal again, whether it's during the second half at a stoppage or maybe in the full-time highlights. That's a push forward, but it's going to roll out of play. It goes back to Cuba, who have some work to do here. Down the stretch, coming down towards the 20 minutes to go mark in this one. Fifth place on the line. Can Bermuda score another? Oh, that was a decent strike. Miranda makes the stop, and she needed to make the stop. It might have been Trott, who's already scored a nice goal at this tournament for Bermuda. Free kick, that's a long range effort, but Miners plucks it out of the air. It's going to be tougher for goalkeepers to manage those long-range shots as the rain continues to come down, but Miners made that look easy. Calvo Blanco trying to maneuver. Cuba will get a refresh. And good follow-up by Daniela. That stays with Cuba here. Just over 20 minutes plus stoppage left. Of course, we've seen Cuba have a 2-0 lead and unfortunately lose it yesterday. Can they pull out a Uno reverse card, if you will, in the second half of this one? 20 minutes plus stoppage to go to try and pull this off. If they can, as they get a corner here, that'll help. We would have a penalty kick shootout to decide this one. That's the same theme for the rest of our games today. All the games are for placement in League B, and if any of the games end in a tie, we will go to a penalty kick shootout. Good ball in from Isaac. It was cleared away. Recycled by Diaz. Nice ball back down the line to find Isaac, who cuts in field. Lovely 1-2. Back to Isaac. Good cross into the middle. Oh, it's touched just wide. Wonderful build-up play. That's the best we've seen from Cuba today. That's more like it from them based on what we've seen in this tournament. And Annalise Calvo Blanco put off right at the end by a late challenge. And she just couldn't quite put it on goal. Could that be a sign of things to come? More things and chances and opportunities like that are what is going to get Cuba back in the game. Ooh, but this is a push and a chase up ahead. Bermuda could add on, but Miranda saves. Huge stop for Cuba. Gibbons Thomas tried to put this one away, but Allison Miranda keeps Cuba's heart beating in this fifth place game. Gigantic stop, and Bermuda have a corner upcoming. From the corner. Oh, it was fizzed in there. Deflects off of the side netting and back out. It's going to be another corner. From the corner, Lopez steps in nicely. Bermuda win the ball back, however. And then Blanco comes to get it for Cuba. Doesn't quite have the numbers, but she's gonna give this a shot. Blanco looking for space, and she ends up getting dispossessed just outside of the penalty area. As that ball goes out of play and the sun pokes through a little bit. here in Trinidad and Tobago. Looks like both teams will get a chance here to regroup with what appears to be a cooling break here in the second half. Again, Bermuda took the lead in the first half. It was Samuels, the aid of a deflection, to give Bermuda a 1-0 lead in the 17th minute. Here's that goal. It was a mad scramble inside the penalty area, but Samuels is able to deflect it in. So much traffic inside the penalty area, but she took the express lane off the ricochet. That gave Bermuda a 1-0 lead to work with at the half. But then, we just saw one of the best goals of the tournament. I think that's fair to say. For the second goal, pouring rain, all the weather, doesn't matter. Milan Gibbons-Thomas on the turn, and she absolutely rockets this in for a second goal for Bermuda. What a finish. Nothing the goalkeeper could do about that. Nothing any goalkeeper could do about that. A glorious goal. And that is where we stand. Any excuse to show that goal again. What a finish. And out of the cooling break, Cuba are going to have about 15 minutes plus stoppage to try and claw the two goals back. The rain looks to have stopped for the moment. The sun has returned. That's always good to see. And from the restart, Bermuda are going to be told to retake the throw. Well, Cuba will have to defend this. And to be fair, they got it cleared initially, but it could lead to a chance. It's lovely skill. Wonderful footwork. This is an unbelievably good weaving run. But at the end of it, it is very well defended. Daly Outerbridge, wonderful skill. But she stood up by Asia Galina, who made the stop defensively. Oh, great work on both ends of the coin there. And it's a goal kick. From the throw, that's a nice take. Flytes gets into the penalty area. This is what she does best. And the ball into the middle looking for Blanco is cut out. But it falls for Isaac! And it was a good strike with her off boot. It was with her left. It's gonna bend wide of the target. Now Isaac has scored already in this tournament. Not far away from scoring another. Miners was interested, but it does miss the target. Ooh, that's pushed through. Miners is there to collect, however. Well, she needed to make sure with Calvo Blanco in pursuit for Cuba, who still need that spark if they are going to make a comeback. Thank you. Ooh, that's going to be a chance here. Cuba could get one back. Oh, what a save. Nalini Miners is able to stop Annalise Calvo Blanco at pretty much point blank range. That has been Cuba's best chance. Great work by Blanco to get in behind. But Miners helps to cut down the angle and comes up with a gigantic stop. Isaac from the corner. The shot is sent over the top by Lopez. Again, Cuba comes so close to finding a lifeline here. Isaac, it's a quick giveaway. 1-2, back to Isaac. And Isaac's shot is blocked, out for another Cuba corner. Well, it feels like Cuba have a chance here. Can they just get the one? 10 minutes left. Isaac takes it short. Flites to the top of the penalty area. It's played in behind. Isaac arrives! And the shot is just a whisker away. It flies just over the frame. And it's another close call for Cuba. Isaac gets the ball back. And then Flites trying to, again, maneuver a pass through, has it cut out. Miners able to play it ahead, although Bermuda pushed themselves into this near side corner. Chance to maybe follow up here. This is Daniela putting the pressure on. Bermuda have to be careful here, the way they handle this situation. And they do keep it with a throw. Now we'll see a substitution here. Suzette Lacia is going to come on for Cuba. And Amaya James is going to enter for Bermuda. Poked ahead by Ulasia. Good follow-up as well. But the referee is going to bring this back. It's a free kick. Now, it was such a good flurry from Cuba in that last sequence, but Bermuda's defensive acumen really shined. And now you're starting to wonder, are Cuba going to be a little bit short on time? Down the stretch here, 7 minutes and change. Plus, you would think some stoppage time due to the cooling break and some substitutions. What is two going to be too much to ask? We've seen Cuba score two goals in quick time at this tournament. If they're going to get fifth place, they're going to have to do it again. Otherwise, Bermuda, after they had some tough times in the attack yesterday, they have really bounced back well today. They deserve a lot of credit. Don Vickers, his staff, and the players have responded extremely well today. after the tough day they had yesterday. But Cuba are going to keep on fighting, we know that. They are going to keep going till the final whistle. Well, the whistle goes. That will be a free kick. And it will go Bermuda's way here. Remember, our second game after this one, we'll have Barbados taking on Grenada. Let's look at the last challenge. Our second game here in League B. It's all going to be about lucky number 13th place in the League B standings. And then our last game of the day will have 7th place on the line. That'll be Antigua and Barbuda taking on Curaçao to finish out our day's action here. We have 5 minutes left here in game one of three, part of a triple header. Well, that's going to be a foul. Cuba wins the free kick. It's played quickly. Oh, and it's touched past the goalkeeper. Can Lopez get it? No. More huge defending from Bermuda. They're going to allow Cuba to get the throw, but more importantly, they didn't allow Cuba to score. That is massive defending there. Miners committed, didn't get to it, but Lopez was shielded away. And now Cuba will have to settle for a corner. Corner is taken well, but it bounces past everybody. Still a chance for a re-entry. Flites into the middle. This is Blanco on the turn. And it's touched away from her. A push and a chase up the other end. Can Bermuda really slam the door shut? Into the middle it goes. Miranda, who's been solid today, he's able to come up with it. Like Bermuda are getting two changes prepared. Get to that in a moment. That is going to sneak through. It's a bit of a foot race here. Oh, the goalkeeper overran it. But Miranda recovers with Mayari Trot trying to get on the end of it. Looked like Miranda had it pretty comfortably, but then it slipped out of her hands. And her actual boots are what bails her out here. In that sequence. And now Cuba have a chance here. Blanco, one-on-one, but her touch is too firm. And Miners collects again. And with 2 minutes plus stoppage left, I'm not sure if Cuba is gonna have enough chances. We'll see. That might have been their last big opportunity to get back in. Two changes for Bermuda. Kaylee Dowling and Jada O'Brien are going to come on. Trot and the goal scorer, Gibbons Thomas, are going to come out. And Gibbons Thomas gets a wonderful hand from the Bermuda supporters here in Trinidad and Tobago. What a goal she scored. in order to give Bermuda that two-goal cushion that they currently enjoy in this fifth-place game. Oh, that's lovely build-up play. Bermuda have a chance to put a ribbon on top. Was that a push in the back? Referee had a good look at it. Says no. That was right on the edge, bare minimum on the edge of the penalty area. Cuba get a free kick up the other end. Cuba keep fighting. They're gonna win a throw-in on the near side, and now we wait to see how much stoppage time there's gonna be at the end. I think Cuba would need probably 3 or 4 minutes minimum of stoppage time if they're gonna have a chance at this. Bermuda defensively continue to be up to the task. Any last-ditch tackles, goalkeeping saves, they've come up with it all down the stretch. Throw in on the near side. Or is it going to be a free kick here? We'll wait and see what the referee decides. Oh, there's the stoppage time. That is not what Cuba were hoping for. Just the 1 minute. And I don't think, barring something unbelievable here, that that's going to be enough. But we know Silvio Minoso's side, they're going to keep going all the way here. Isaac will take the corner. Or beg your pardon, the free kick. Sends in a good ball, but again, Bermuda defensively stand tall. They'll come up with possession as well. Could still be a little bit more time added on because of the substitutions. I think there's maybe a maximum of 30 more seconds left to play here. And Bermuda have it right where they want it with a 2-goal lead. Cuba will clear. That's another good touch to keep it away from Blanco, who's been a big threat in an attacking sense, but Bermuda have done enough to keep Cuba off the score sheet, and that's been tough to do at this tournament. Bermuda will get a shot away. Miranda makes the stop, and that's that, full time here in Trinidad and Tobago. Bermuda finish with a flourish at the CONCACAF Girls Under 15 Championship. They finish fifth here in League B. Nyla Samuels and Milan Gibbons-Thomas are the heroes in the end. And Milan Gibbons-Thomas gave us a memory, to say the least, with that second goal. What a finish. And Bermuda, you talk about bouncing back after yesterday. They recover swimmingly today, really, in some of the rain as well. And they finish this tournament off with a huge victory against a very good Cuba side that can certainly keep their heads held high, that's for sure. But they do lose for the first time at this tournament in their final game at this tournament. On top of that, it's the first time that Cuba have been held scoreless at the tournament. That really is a testament to how well Bermuda finished the game off defensively. The likes of Miners, Barry, Glasgow, and others making huge defensive stops. Amaya James in there as well, Jada O'Brien, all helping the defensive cause for Don Vickers' side. And Bermuda, talk about a wonderful ending to their tournament. After finishing second in their group, and again, they were so close to moving on even further. But the Dominican Republic, beat them yesterday, and you started to wonder, well, how were they going to look today? Well, they looked really, really good, pretty much from start to finish. Cuba, again, in the first half, they struggled. They brought on reinforcements at halftime, and that did change the game. There's no question about that. Blanco, Lopez, Flites, Diaz as well. They all came on. They all made a positive impact on the game. But Bermuda were just too much in the end. They took their two big chances. They come out as winners and fifth place finishers. Before we take a break, before game two, we get a chance to recap game one. And you'll be excited to know that we will get to see the Gibbons-Thomas goal one more time. But before that, we see the bright start that Bermuda had. They created some good chances in the early parts of the first half, and that really was a sign of things to come. And then from the corner, this is in the 17th minute, bounced around, a couple of big defensive moments from Cuba, but Samuels gets the ricochet, and it bounces in, maybe even bounced off the post on the way through as well. Multiple deflections, and it goes in just underneath Miranda's grasp. And that gave Bermuda a 1-0 lead in the first half. And that would be your halftime score as well. Huge celebrations there. And then this is where Gibbons-Thomas really started to get flowing in the right direction. Lovely run. Decent ball in as well. Big block from Asia Galina for Cuba to make sure that Bermuda didn't add on to their lead in the first half. And then we move on to half number two. More chances for Bermuda. That was an opportunity blocked, and then, well, lovely skill here from Glasgow, and her shot deflects wide and out of play. But Bermuda kept on pushing even through all the rain and the storm that briefly came through. But here's the goal of the tournament. Gibbons-Thomas with a turn, and she absolutely mashes that in to the back of the net to give Bermuda a 2-0 lead, one that they would not relinquish. And then again, more opportunities. Bermuda really tried to slam the door shut. Big saves from Allison Miranda made sure that Bermuda would not score again. And I must say, Cuba had some big opportunities up the other end, that is for sure. This chance, I should say, and the shot from Isaac would go wide of the target. And Annalise Calvo Blanco, she had the two big chances. This was the first one. Big save from Miners at point blank range to keep it at 2-0. That one really had to go in to keep Cuba's chances alive. But Bermuda, brilliant from start to finish. They win it by 2-0. At the end of the tournament, they finish in fifth place. That'll do it for game number one. Bermuda are your winners. They finish in fifth in League B, and they beat Cuba by 2-0. We'll take a brief break. Game number two, with 13th place on the line, is Barbados and Grenada. It's coming up after the break.